everybody. Next session, we have a speaker from India, named Rahul. Please welcome Rahul. Because he worked in the automotive as a happiness engineer, then he will describe his work and how he used WordPress and help other people use WordPress. Okay, thank you.
Hello, everyone. How's lunch?
Hey.
Everyone. Okay, so my name is Rahul and I work for Automatic. I'm a happiness engineer. I actually love helping people, so I chose first client servicing. Now I'm in customer support full time. And the topic is like, because I have been using WordPress since 2011 with different roles. I used to ghostwrite it and I used to do different kind of things. And then I made my own sites and sold them. And then I helped clients do that. And then now I help so many users do that on a daily basis. Use WordPress, WordPress.com now. And I have used it and I have come from a very small town. So having internet was like a God gift, because otherwise it would be very difficult to have a career or unless I chose to like move to a very big city. Let's get started. So the hunger as a like the journey starts as a student in 2011 when I actually broke my knee, and I was in college that time. So I had a knee surgery and I had the entire semester off. So I was like, I have to make the leg heal and I have to work towards earning some pocket money for myself during that semester. And also, there was a big concern with employability in India at that time. It still is that, and I read an article that Indian youth is not unemployed, they are unemployable. So I'm like, I have to hack it. I have to become employable at the end of my college. And the reason was like, I was like, what to do in this semester when I'm home, I cannot travel to college, and I have to like, because my doctor gave me complete bed rest for a semester. So I had like 4 or 5 months. Then I found a senior of mine in college who lived very close to my home. He was making some tech blogs that time, and he needed a writer kind of person to help him with the blogs. And I was like, I am doing nothing for the next 4 or 5 months, and I would like to get involved. And he was like, okay, because he trusted me because I was his junior in college, and he gave me that opportunity. That it started, like I started to make some pocket money, I started to utilize that bed rest time, and I came to know, I discovered that okay, you can also learn and earn a living from the internet, because I had like WordPress, all the blogs were on WordPress, which I was that time a writer and editor at. And somehow English also helped developing the English language, like communication, and also learning to write better because it is not my first language. So because college is a time when we try to like discover ourselves, build some skills for the real world, and I think that was kind of like, though it was a surgery, a setback, but I tried to utilize it in a positive way. I improved on these things. And from early on in life, like I did not like wearing pants and shoes and everything. I was like, I would wear a sarong kind of thing we have in India, and I'll sit at home. I was not very much sporty ever. So my mother used to say that, how would you go in an office where, like, how is it possible even? Because they would have proper dress code. I'm like, okay, I'll wear a shirt and then I tie a sarong because they won't see under the table. But that time I did not know, this was like very earlier, but that time I did not know I could work from home, I could ghostwrite, I could work on sites, I could do so many things on the internet. And since like the employment opportunity issue, started finding new stuff in during that time and during the rest of the college time. So I discovered that there is something called apprenticeship model of learning, that there are always people ahead of you in the game, and if you want to learn, you should always ask them, and most people will help you, and help you in the sense they will also need help. So they will be happy to collaborate, because if they have the skills, you also have the time. So both things, sometimes it turns into something better as well. And you can become better at things if you do them longer and be more consistent about it. So this way I could, like, from post writing on different sites to learn how they are split and stuff, and everything is done on WordPress. It was free and only required effort, attention and work. So I learned that. Then I was like, what next? The hunger for growth came, that yes, okay, I have to get ahead, what, learn new things. So I discovered that whatever you learn or whatever we call, like, this is something I would like to share with people, is it comes from our mistakes and our very core personality interest as well. Like, if this is like kind of a favorite thing, like, we have to ask ourselves, what is our favorite, like, what is our flavor, what we bring to the table, because that cannot be brought by anybody else. Only you can bring you. No one is youer than you. There is that kind of idea, right? So, because it is very, very important to realize that what you will do, only you can do it. Your flavor and your interest, everything you do, and your mistakes will teach you a lot. So, and there are mistakes. Early on, we all make mistakes, and we should keep on making mistakes if we want to learn and discover some new things. So after this, after college got over, I was like, okay, my goal of employability also was achieved. I got a free placement offer in college. I became an editor, webmaster, and stuff. I did that for some time, and then I left that because another surgery came into life. My father had a heart attack, so I had to come back. And they were like, you are important, so you have to work from home, don't leave like that. And I'm like, okay, I will, once my father's health has improved, I will start work. But then I was doing work for them also, and I learned how to customize websites with WordPress using WooCommerce, because it happened in 2014-15 where WooCommerce was like also booming, and I used to get some same kind of senior, they were also involved in WordPress. I used to get work from them, and that time I was not like, I have to get the clients or I have to build a business, but I was like, I have to take care of the family and help them out, and also make sure that I learn and I keep on growing, like, because it's like, you sometimes we do things to pass the time as well. And we do things which actually we like, and we are not very concerned that time about the money aspect. But money also comes in, so it is a win-win situation. When you discover that, okay, you like doing this, and you are working with people who you like, and then so things always came because I asked for them, and I was never shy of asking for help or work from anyone who I found interesting. Performer is doing great things. And I mean, why I'm saying this is because I was at home in a small city, and that is what I wanted to make sure, that I have spent time with my family, I have been home as well, but I keep on learning and working on the internet as well. So I did other things as well. Now I was writing copy for a few clients, I used to manage some remote teams, we used to buy and sell news sites as well, because that's how, like, the entire ghostwriting thing grew to become. We were getting very nice copy projects, we were getting writing projects. projects, big ones where we had remotely working writers, we used to manage them, and then I used to make and sell new sites as well. The end, like when this happened, when I like properly it was going on, that I can set in home anywhere I want where there is internet, and I'm working with people in the West, and they were always happy that okay, I had good English and I could be available for them. Because sometimes the thing is, people are all very much money minded, and they are like, okay, I'm doing this to make money because the Western currency is heavier and ours is weaker. But my goal was to just keep working, doing things, learning new things. And I made mistakes because sometimes when there are decisions, I never followed the way greed was taken. I was like, I have to remain what I am. Otherwise, there is no point if I forget my values, if I don't stay the person, like, I'm eternally who I am. And internet is great in that way that you can choose what you want to do. And you can keep on learning because a new lesson is a Google search away, right? So then after this was happening, and up until like 2016, this was going great. Then I discussed with few of my friends, like, what next? Like, I joked about it that either it is do a higher education MBA or get married. Like, what next? And like, so, but then I was like, I should step up in career as well and go take some risks. And it's like that complicated craving was like, it was a kind of a problem when, and that came like when I tried to learn more about myself, that we accept the love we think we deserve. So I was like, okay, this is enough. Like, I can work for at sometimes at night, sometimes at day, and I can do this. This in the like the, I have reached the highest point. That is what I can do from my home. And like, if I want to do more, then I have to maybe go out of the city. But what things change? Like, I learned another thing. I took some risk. I actually invested some money, and we used to sell products. And because I know new e-commerce nicely, so we did drop shipping from China to US a lot. I took some risk. I actually was doing mostly content based on website work, but now here I learned how pricing works, how to sell stuff, how to properly think like a business. And that was great, that was really nice. But the still at the back of the mind, still I was thinking, okay, I'm from a small town, I've worked with small startups or small clients. But then, like, can I apply, or even I'm fit to apply at a company like Automatic? Because in my mind, it was like, I don't have a degree from a very reputed college, or I haven't worked abroad or something. But as I was trying to discover myself, to become self-aware, I was like, okay, let's prepare and then apply. Let's see. Because that is like, it's like that you always have to test yourself as well. Like, life is an experiment. Like, you if you want to achieve something, you can. If you know the end result, it's not an experiment, right? We can see how it works. So WordPress community, I have been involved since 2015. I was a volunteer, and I try to organize meetups as well in India. The friends I gained from that community taught me a lot. Some were like really good developers. They knew that I could sell stuff. So different kind of people you meet, and you learn different kind of things about WordPress, about life, because we had different kinds of discussions. So from them I learned that it is okay to take another risk which is not involving money based risk, which is actually a challenge to myself. The challenge was like, because I had this inferiority complex that would I apply in that American company, because I was like from a very small place. But I did, again, friends from the community, and they actually helped me in this. And so the final lesson I learned was in kindness. So I was not being kind with myself. So that is why I was not being kind with others as well. So the it is like really important to give yourself time, with time, take one step ahead every day, and then keep like it. WordPress is also evolving, right? So we are also evolving. It, with every step and every, like let's say every 6 months or every year, we should look up. But we should not be like greedy, like, okay, yesterday I was here. We should give ourselves also time, be kind, and give ourselves time to evolve as well. So the risk, every risk is rewarded in a different way. Sometimes you trust people, like you are good friends with them and you get into work or business together, but they also cheat you. But they can only cheat you once. Or then also you learn that, okay, I should have taken a better decision there. Also, with the different aspect, like from, like I did not even have a side, like when I started writing, ghostwriting for my like friends here in college, and then to having my own clients and to have like that journey, internally it was very challenging, because I actually did not like have that in mind that I am doing something great, but I was doing this to like, okay, pass the time, do something I was interested, not like having a lot of seriousness in mind, because I'm like, okay, let's do. But somehow when you take a risk and it actually teaches you in a way you did not thought, like, okay, I can actually achieve something, and I can not feel like an imposter in the room. So that is also, that comes from kindness and acceptance, is what I learned. And there is like one thing that I want to share, and in the end is like that sometimes it is important to just keep living, keep bringing your time, you will be fine. Because when you start, you cannot know the end. And if you know the end, I think it would be very good. Because if you like playing games and you know how it ends, or if you know the end of the novel you are reading, or the movie you are watching, the suspense, then it's not fun. So it's like, if you are trying to use WordPress or build something with it, and if you think that it will work or it will not work, you're not confident about it, I think just keep going, keep taking steps that you feel are right, because they are right at that time. And we can look back and see, okay, that this was a good decision or this was a bad decision.
Thank you so much.
I learned using the computer in school.
Oh, that's cool.
you started work, started managing remote teams, what were some of the mistakes you learned at the beginning of doing that?
Setting expectations. Because I think people are different from different cultures. You see different people, and sometimes there is a big cultural difference when it comes to diverse teams. Remotely, you get like people from different teams. Like I had people from Dubai, from Pakistan, from India, from Bangladesh, from Malaysia as well. Like we were doing work, we were working together in lots of projects there. So it was like you have to actually, the biggest lesson is like setting expectation as in if you are managing the team. But again, the biggest personal lesson is to empathize with everyone. Because they, if you are a point of contact for them, you should be very open to anything from them. They can share anything with you. It's not that yet, there should not be barrier of entry to any question. They should not, like, so that is why talking to them and also like talking to them about their personal life as like, because you are working with them daily, right? Or like at least twice a month, twice a week, you have the call or you get in touch with them. So empathy and setting expectations, because sometimes it happens like people, it used to happen with us, like they wanted it on that day, but people here have a festival. So I used to set expectations on both sides that yes, that is important that they have a festival. And I also like told them that your last day you have to take. And sometimes I have to wrangle like, okay, if there is a festival in another country, maybe somebody from India can help. So that is also important. Like, because it is actually the team you build or a remote team you have to manage. It looks daunting and it is daunting, but with time, like one step at a time. You cannot apply all the lessons also in one day. That will also be like, what you need to do, it has totally changed. It will be like that. So one time, maybe if you see a problem, try to make sure you solve it or make it ready for the people, because they trust you. Also, one more lesson I would share that, and I got blamed for this a lot in India. I used to pay like the people who were working with me $8, not in INR, because I was like, they should also feel that they are working for the West, not for some Indian person. And they actually liked that about me, and they always gave me priority as well. Like if Rahul's email, Rahul is sending an email, or Rahul sent something, they also prioritize, because they knew that I'm not treating them as a freelancer. Because I knew how it was like when I was a freelancer, like not having many people with me. I was alone. Thank you.
For your freelance project, how you get that job and how you share the customer?
Ask, I always ask.
Okay.
So I would say I was lucky, because I always asked people who had too many projects. I'm like, okay, I can, if I have 100, I can take 5, and if I can deliver 5 well, then I can take 10. And money was always like the first project I ever like did with any new person. Money was just settled by them, because that was like, I am also trusting, because I cannot run to US that time. Like, I could not run to US if they did not pay me. So you have to trust, because in remotely you have to trust them once. Yeah. And assume that everybody has good intentions, because most of the time they do. Unless or until something breaks or something bad happens, nobody, I don't think, the internet is such a big pie, they don't have a reason to cheat, I guess. Because everything lives on. If they post something bad about me, if I did, then bad karma, I am, right? So people realize that as well. If I like pay them better and also treat them nicely, they will tell that to their friends and people they know that, okay, Rahul is nice. He doesn't treat me like a freelancer, he treats me like
an equal person. So they actually become friends. It's not that a work relationship, it has to be. Because if a project breaks or something happens, friends solve it. Partners or stuff, they leave. I feel that. So, and I'm also here. I actually had, like, when I used to make and sell new sites, I had a partner whom I in project whom I have never met still. And it's been like, okay, since 2014 to November 2016, we used to make and sell new sites. And we had teams too. But I have never met the person. But we still have, like, we call, and these are like a brother. So you become friends, you become family too. Remotely, never even meeting.
And about the corporate charging, how you charge?
Okay, charging was like I told, like first project was always like they decide. And then, see, that is actually like a, like knowing or like dating. You know, you also know the other person and they also know you. So one of my clients that time, he was so impressed that I was always available on Sundays because I never had Sunday evening plans. I still don't know what to do on a Sunday evening.
Payment-wise,
that evolves. Like when you are new, like when you are trying to experiment and learn, you price accordingly, and then with the experiment and the kind of big projects, you increase.
By budget, right? Because you say that.
No, hourly also, man hours also. Yeah, but that depends on what. But initially, everybody I think starts over. Then there's a. And one more secret I will tell that whatever you have unlocked, people want that too. So when I used to like sell dropshipping products, people hired me as a consultant too, like, okay, we want to do that too. Can you set up everything and tell us everything and we'll pay you? So that was also like, because I had unlocked that. I knew what is the season, what time it will sell and how to research that. So that is like, you can sit at home and do it. You don't need to have a degree or, because, and I also joke about it that, yeah, internet is a gift from God, or internet is God, because otherwise, like, it is not, it would have not been possible to put food on the table. But WordPress, internet, these things actually helped me a lot.
Any questions? For me, one more question.
Yes, yes.
How you get your customer from Indonesia? You said, from around the world, your customer.
So there are many freelance sites, and actually I joined one very late because, like I said, I used to contact the person who has 100 projects and get 5 projects, and they actually referred me. If I did like some projects with them, and they're like, Rahul is reliable. So reliability is actually much more important. So, and that way you will get more also. And the thing is, I never like traveled or something, but I was always available. That was they were very happy that we were going to the church on Sunday. It was Sunday morning for them and Sunday evening for me. And we used to have that 3-hour call, and we used to discuss the entire week that happened. They were very happy that I have to go to church and this is the time I have and Rahul is available. So that is also very important sometimes. I know Sunday evenings can be difficult, but this is like when you are starting out, sell or actually develop a skill which people are actually looking for is also like right now most people in if you say WordPress, most people are discovering Gutenberg, but if you discover it faster, the chances are that all the projects that come will be yours. Also in dropshipping, every season try running some ads, make a site on WooCommerce and sell some sort of stuff. Whatever, anything. There are sometimes you know a manufacturer, you can sell that also. Anything, just try it. Don't lose too much money, but when you experiment, you will learn a lot. And I'm pretty sure that you will earn as well, as an experiment. And I did it from India. There were so many problems with the shipping and stuff, but I still managed. So I think some places it would be easier as well. Any other question?
Yes? I read from your website the word happiness engineer.
Yes.
Quite neat for me. Please explain.
Okay. So, okay. I actually
have a like, today you send happiness to the customer.
Okay. We try to help users use our products, WordPress.com, WooCommerce, Flipkart, so they can have any questions. Sometimes I get contact from users, they are like, I'm 60, but I want to make this site and it is very new to me. So trying to explain them everything in simple language, helping them get a website and or a blog. Sometimes they want to write about the life they have lived. And they are retired now, but they want to write a journal. As simple as, once I helped the Australian politician, they were trying to run for another like election. So it is exciting because it keeps you curious and I like to learn new things. That is so that every day you will have a new kind of a website or a new kind of a issue will come and you will stay curious and you will try to solve it and help the user. And especially when they say God bless you and stuff like that, thank you so much for helping me. That actually makes my day. So that is what our happiness engineer does. Any other question?
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.